Mancini, and I'm a missionary in Danbury, Connecticut. Welcome to Western Connecticut State University. This is where I work every day. This is my mission field. I was a student here for a long time, and most of the time that I was here, I wasn't a Christian. I surrendered my life to the Lord during my senior year here, and God called me back a few years after that just to respond to the stuff that He's doing here on campus. And I'm just really, really excited for the stuff that He is doing here. And yeah, so this is it. Welcome to WestCon.
Yeah, New England, man. It's it's known as rocky ground, rocky soil. It's a really spiritually dark region in our country. Like, the cultural norm here is not to be someone who goes to church. The cultural norm here is to be someone who thinks that, you know, faith in God, specifically faith in Jesus, is silly.
It makes evangelism really, really challenging in this area, because the moment that you try to actually, like, care for someone and love someone and reach out to them, you're being so countercultural that people just shut off to everything that you're doing. But in that, there's, like, this amazing stuff happening, right? Like, the light of Jesus is shining in these really dark places, and this is one of those places that's happening. So I just want to show you around campus and show you just what we're doing here. So the spring semester, we kicked off these new Bible studies. And the first week of the Bible studies, man, I was so excited because I had 8 students come. Over the course of the 3 days, I had 8 students, which is, you know, way more than I had had all semester before that, you know, where I was just plowing this, you know, rocky soil, right? The spot that we met was in the cafeteria. This is the lower cafeteria. And there we were at this table in the middle of this really public place at, like, the most public hour of it, you know, just looking at God's Word and seeing, like, how we could walk it out on our campus. That was always the focus of the Bible studies, was how we could walk our faith out on this campus. By the end of the semester, the last day of our Bible study, they had 14 other students. 3 of them had never been to a Bible study on campus before, and one of them was the president of the pagan club on campus, who was having these spiritual conversations with one of my leaders. And they had this huge Bible study, right? 16 students. You know, 3 who'd never been on campus, 1 who was a non-Christian, and they're having this huge Bible study in the middle of everything. And it was just beautiful. It was amazing. I'm just really, really excited about what the Lord's doing in the dorms here this year. We're gonna be putting on, like, kind of Christian events and Christian seminars in the dorms. Part of the responsibility of the RAs is to offer programs for the students in their buildings. To really, you know, foster kind of whole student development, you know, and part of that is spirituality. So we have a green light to bring the gospel into the dorms, which is just really, really amazing. And then I'm going to be kind of empowering them and helping them to plan these events to present the gospel to students. And then after that, we have students who are in place who are ready to lead Bible studies in the dorms, which is just so huge. I mean, that's just at a state school in Connecticut, like, that's just unheard of. It's epic, man. It's so huge that we are able to be able to be doing this in the dorms. And I'm just so excited to see what the fruit is going to be from this. I mean, it's going to be, you know, by the grace of God, man, it's just going to be unbelievable. This house has been just, like, such a huge blessing for my family. I mean, it's been amazing. Like, not only is it super strategic for campus, but it really just serves and just for a lot of our needs. The ministry on campus right now is in kind of a scary spot as far as funding goes. A lot of people don't see this as a mission field, you know. And when people feel like, you know, they want to give to missions, you know, they decide that they're going to give to some, you know, to a missionary family in South America or in Africa. So it's hard. It's really challenging to raise funds to continue this ministry. And right now, I'm in a place where it's getting really, really tight, and there's some potential for me to actually not even be able to continue this ministry here. But all that being said, right? I mean, like, God is so faithful, and I know that God is going to provide for our ministry here. And for this kid out here, excuse me for 1 second. What's up, guys? I've given everything to this call, you know? Like, God, it's so clear that God called me here, you know? I had, like, a sweet job, a nice house, you know? Like, family, I had it like it was set, you know? And, like, God called me out of all that stuff to, like, be here. And I know that He's gonna provide, right? I mean, the only reason I'm saying that is because I know that He's been faithful in providing, and He's gonna continue to. But I need support of people who see this as a mission field and who believe that God is moving here and that it's worth supporting the work here. So I guess, like, to anyone watching this, the thing that I would ask you to do is just to really just bring it to God. Just pray and ask him if he's calling you to support ministry here on this campus.